Good evening and welcome to the Health and Wellness Show here on COARadio.com. It is that time of the month again, gentlemen. It's so true.
Say that again.
Yeah, it's that time of the month.
Say and thank that again, you so but slower.
for tuning in to listen to our great show. We have a great guest this evening as well.
Oh,
and
thank you.
Before I get there, I am Maryann Castello, your host of the Health and Wellness Show. And I am sitting here with my musical director, Rich Chlanda.
Hey, thank you very much.
And our very own engineer, Art Ackerman.
Hooray! Yay!
Oh. Hey, he has a hand. See, he exists.
That's all you got with the hand.
You're like Mr. Wilson from Tool Time that would never like look over the fence, I swear. Which is really good. And
no, we got a picture today.
Well, that's
He's
good.
He's going to be on social media today.
Oh, nice.
And Richie, hey. How are you
hey.
Doing?
Hey! I'm good. What's up?
Really? That's what you're going to say? You have some news.
I do?
Yeah, since you're musical director, I'm going to talk about music.
Good. Okay,
is that
good.
A good thing?
Yeah, that's good. We're good.
Now, as we said on last month's show, is that Rich Chlanda is now back with the legendary rock band Nectar.
Hooray!
Yay! Yeah!
Who will be doing their 50th anniversary tour.
Yep.
And you have the members beside yourself. We have Mo Moore, one of the original bassists of Nectar. Yay! Yay! Special shout out. And also we have the drummer, who's great, and that's Ronnie Howden. So Ronnie. He'll be there Yay! As well. And we have our very own Rich Chlanda. And on acoustic guitar and some bass, there's Randy Dembo as well. Yay!
Yay!
And the new keyboard player that we know so well, Kendall Scott,
Kendall.
Is part of it.
Right.
And Nectar was always known for their brilliant and magnificent light shows at all their concerts. And the fabulous Mick Brockett is
Brockett.
Back as well to do those original shows for the tour. And the reason why I'm announcing that is that I heard a rumor that Nectar is actually scheduled to be at Progstock this year.
Yep.
And that is in Rahway on October 13th. I think you guys are performing there.
Yes.
At the Union County Performing Arts Center.
Yes.
Isn't that the same date as last year?
No, it's a little different.
I'm not sure.
You know
it's
why?
It sounded like the same dates. It,
do you know why?
Like the same.
Because the day they're performing happens to be the best day out of the year.
Your birthday?
It is.
Right. Correct.
It's her birthday.
Absolutely. Right on the day. So,
I'm going to take her to a concert for her birthday.
See, and they're,
that's
but
awesome.
You know what I'm going to ask for? I'm going
to
ask for Nectar.
Maybe
you'll
get backstage passes.
I think I already have those. However, I do believe they need to serenade me for my birthday for at least one song.
I agree with that.
Okay, we'll do that.
And with prog music, their songs could be 16, 17 minutes each.
On stage. No.
Yes. Yeah, I would do it. I just want to see that happen. I'm putting that out there if anybody's listening.
Yeah, well, you
just
know.
Into the universe.
That's a possibility to do that.
It is there. But I don't want to leave her out much longer because I love her because she has the gift of gab.
Yeah, great.
So I'm going to get right to our special guest this evening. Our guest tonight is the CEO and founder of G45 Consulting and the host of her own radio show, Your Career is Calling, that can be heard every Sunday morning. She is also an author and has a new book coming out soon titled Lucky Switch. She will explain to us how she actively solves business problems for her clients, offers advice on their leadership needs, and why she's committed to both your immediate short-term and long-term success. She's here to wave her magic wand, ha ha ha, in this new world of business. Let's welcome our special guest, Wanda Ellett. Welcome.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Pun intended, by the way. I couldn't help myself. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
See, I heard her chiming in, so I can't leave her out anymore on this
side.
Oh,
no, I don't care about that.
I love it. I absolutely love it.
I could have gone off for another 10 minutes. I'll sit here. I don't care.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I will tell you how I caught up with the wonderful Wanda Ellett. It was that Mike Marino, the Jersey boy, bad boy of
it's
comedy.
Jersey bad boy.
man.
The bad boy.
That's
the
right.
bad boy of comedy.
And he is making, actually he makes America Italian again.
Yeah, he does.
Right? And we
Poor
happen
mafia.
To be attending live from my mother's basement. And during that, thank you, Mike Marino, I met the lovely Wanda Ellett. We started talking. Yeah. And you have a lot of helpful information that I thought could be wonderful for our listeners here on the Health and Wellness Show.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I'm very glad to be here today.
I'm glad that you're here. And you brought an in-studio guest.
Yes, I did.
That we decided to mic up and put headphones on that he didn't expect. So let's welcome John also.
Thank you.
You're going to do this. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So we also have John. And we're here to have
my
a lot
brother.
Of fun. Well, the one thing I do want to say is that we have a new sponsor of the show. And the reason why I just want to talk about it is because if you call in and you join our show at 609-241-7103 to maybe get some free advice here from our wonderful Wanda, you could potentially win and be the winner of tonight's actual sponsor of High Tech Low Buds. And we have a set waiting for a lucky winner. So
wow.
just remember, during our show, if you call in at 609-241-7103 and you have not won these before, let me stress that. We always like new winners. Just give a call and you have potential of
okay,
winning
Johnny,
anything
call me.
On the table that's here. So I just thought I'd
Johnny's
throw it
out. Dialing in.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, employees or affiliates of City of Angels are not entitled. No, I'm only kidding.
I already got them.
Actually, we do. And you know what? I have to thank, I have to tell you, I use them and I love them. And because
they are good.
I couldn't leave them on steady, I had to actually use the blinking lights because they mesmerized me.
Not good for murdering people if you're going to be murdering.
No, because they're for safety. They're for safety. And if you're the person that's lighting yourself up for that murder, maybe not.
Yeah.
If you are the murderer going after somebody, you're as good as caught. So they do their thing. They're
like,
safety.
What does it do? It lights up?
They light up. So as you're running or walking, people can see you at night.
Actually, they flash to the beat of the music. They have a setting for that as well.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and the better thing about it, too, is they also hook up to your phone. So you could talk and walk and still have the lights going.
Wow.
So it's my dream come true because now I feel like I'm always on stage, no matter if I'm in the street doing whatever I'm doing. So I love it.
She's a rock star.
So, absolutely.
You're a legend in your own mind.
Yes, I am. Thank you, see? Because spoken like a true career woman. So let's get right to it. Careers. There's so much to know, okay? And you are the CEO and founder of G45 Consulting.
Yeah.
So how did you come up with the company name, and why did you want to create this company?
Well, I was working on Wall Street during the economic meltdown.
So I saw.
It was a nightmare. At the time, I was working at JP Morgan, and I got right-sized. And, you know, it was just painful to watch. There were so many different companies during that economic meltdown. I was working side by side with people who had just joined JP Morgan from Bear Stearns, and they lost all their pension, like everything, like all the money they had accrued, and, you know, and experiencing some of that. I was also working with people from WaMu, Washington Mutual, because they had been absorbed by JP Morgan as well. You know, and at that time, I was at JP Morgan from 2007 through 2010, and that was all during the nightmare. It was a crazy, crazy time.
That was the peak of it, right?
Yeah, that was really the heat of it.
I remember 2008 was really horrible.
Yeah.
You know, like that. I don't want to interrupt you, but I just said, that's a hot spot to be.
Was,
oh, my God.
And to be at JP Morgan was really insanity. I had also worked at AIG for a number of years.
Oh, okay.
And so being on Wall Street day in, day out, the feeling, you know, and the energy was very tense. It was very terse.
Yeah, yeah.
It was interesting, too, because I credit Jamie Dimon. I think he did a lot of things right. And, you know, there were a number of things like, you know, that he did, I felt that were respectable. And like I said, working side by side with some of these people that were, you know, they were right-sized and, you know, absorbed. They had just lost all of their retirement money,
wow.
You know, and you figure like some of the other companies that had, you know, too big to fail, they,
right.
You know, they lost everything.
Yeah.
And, it was really a devastating time. And, you know, through 2010, things were, you know, it was just really insanity. There were a number of reasons, and, you know, that things happened as they did. But I decided that, you know, at that time, you know, I felt that I wanted to start my own firm. And I was at a juncture where, you know, I figured that I could really bring value to different companies. I had been on the other side of the desk for so many years. And, you know, it was painful for me, you know, because some of the companies I know in these vendors, they were missing their steps. You know what I mean? There were things that they could have been doing better. And I felt that I could do, and I've done better. But it was a crazy time.
Oh, you know, I'm sure.
And I got in the doors at a number of different companies, but a lot of these companies, they really, they took everything in house. Like I was working with like American Greetings, Bayer, a number of huge firms.
Well, that you had these huge firms under your belt, what is the single most common concern that you heard from, you know, your clients? What was the single thing that was brought to your attention? Do you recall?
Well, it was interesting at that time. It was interesting because generally my client, I would be going against some of these big, huge firms. And I was very talented in bringing top talent to a lot of these organizations. And it's interesting because they would think like, you know, who am I? You know what I mean? I'm just like, but I network very quickly. And I also am I'm quick to build a relationship with people, a trusted relationship. And I think that's why I'm able to bring top talent. And also, like, I vet people. I've been in the seat of the hiring manager, and I understand some of the pain because some of these recruiters, when I was working with them, trying to hire for a project, sitting in their seat, you know, like, I was pained because it was like, why'd you send this guy to me? He doesn't make any sense.
Right.
You know what I mean? That doesn't fit for me. That doesn't work for me. And I was able to really listen to what their needs and also anticipate their needs. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, you know, it was interesting because with some of these clients, they would say, why did you send this person to me? And I'd be able to articulate it. And they were like, huh. And then they would actually modify their job rec and say, I guess we do need that. And but it was sad because, it was confirmed that, you know, through that time period of 2010, like in the early years, they hired people, not necessarily the best person, which was my candidate. They brought their own person in from, like, you know, who may have been second place, third place, but then they didn't have to pay the recruiting fee. And it was interesting to watch, like, a lot of the things that transpired during that time frame. A lot of companies at that time, they would also... It was painful because they would put jobs out there that were fake to right. tell everybody, we're successful, we're hiring. You got nothing. Right. Wow. You know what I mean? You got nothing. That same job has been out there for 6 months or a year, and they wouldn't hire. And then, like, as they were letting people go, there were people that they would morph the jobs into one person because Joe and Sally left, and then here's Paul, and he's doing the job of... that he was doing, and then Joe and Sally's job. So right. now, sometimes too, like as the transition has occurred, like years have passed, they're looking for a guy like Paul, you know, because they want to replace Paul.
Right.
But that's impossible because he was doing the job. That's not, you know, like you can't have an accountant and marketing guy.
Yeah, it's
like,
hard.
You know what I mean? Like morphed into the thing. So it's kind of funny. It's been an interesting transition. But originally you would ask me too, like, how did I come up with the name of G45?
Yeah.
And it's actually a consulting. I was looking for, at the time there was a new element on the periodic table. And but it wasn't, yeah, because so I was like, oh my god, it's a new element. And originally the name of my company was Go To Consulting, and there was this guy who also had the name of Go To Consulting, and he was doing bad things, and I was fielding all these calls for him, and I was just like, I need to rebrand. So then, in, you know, I started branding myself as G45 Consulting. G45 Consulting is actually a consulting firm in Europe.
Ah,
and
okay.
It's kind of funny, you know, because there was a new element, so it was kind of, I was thinking, oh, I was going along that line of a G, it was
the
G something.
G-Force.
Yeah, it was a
in
G-Force,
hiring.
And then there was like the G6 song that came out, and but then I was like, I saw this G45 consult, you know, there was a consulting firm, and I was going to do G45 consulting, so I was like, I wanted to stay with like go-to and that kind
right.
of thing. So
actually, it's kind of cool. I like to hear how people come up with names for their companies.
Yeah, it's kind of bizarre.
It really is bizarre sometimes. Now, I have a question. Do you have any recommendations for any of our listeners who don't know what they want to do for a career? Like me. I could walk into an office and I'll just be like, you have any positions? No, we don't have any open. Well, do you have any open for an office ornament? I would do that. And I think I could qualify. So, like, do you get people coming to you, as ridiculous as this sounds as I'm talking, but, like, do they come to you and say, hey, I really do not know what I want to do?
Yeah, and, you know, in that time, it's really, you know, time for self-reflection. And, you know, I encourage them to, you know, let's schedule some time to work through some different things. And you know, I can do some coaching with them on a regular basis and, you know, encourage them to really figure out what they can do and what, you know, what's your current situation? Because there's that passion and everybody has that idea of like, I want to do what my passion is. And, you know, that doesn't pay the bills. You know what I mean? Like, I want to sit home and crochet blankets all day. That doesn't pay
we
the bills.
We have a musician sitting right next to us.
You're preaching to the choir
I'm
over here.
Preaching to the choir, you know what I mean? Like, what you love to
paid
do.
Paid the
all
bills
day.
In the 80s.
Yeah.
I made the bills in the 80s too. I'm still paying.
Yeah. You know, yeah, but you got to figure out, like, what's going to, and sometimes, you know, I had somebody who was, they were very passionate and they wanted to get a paid fireman position, you know, mm-hmm. and they were working so hard to do this. And, you know, he was a chef as well. It was just like, well, you know, it's kind of disparate. But then he realized, too, that, you know, after a time that you needed to pay the bills, but he did a volunteer gig.
But that's convenient, you know? Being a chef and a fireman all at the same time. You could burn your place down and be able to know how to put it out.
No,
baby, baby, light my fire.
Yeah. Medium well.
There you go. Job well done.
Yeah, job well done. You're here all week. Try the veal. And,
she does get it. And see, there it is. I think I was just fired. Well, that's going to bring us to our, as we're talking about food, I'm sitting here on a health and wellness show.
Yeah.
And every month I cannot get these two gentlemen here, Rich and Art, to change. I see candy. I see Dunkin' Munchkins over here.
You got candy?
You've already rated it when we were in the room alone. And I'm giving it up right now because I saw him take handfuls of candy. Okay? And coffee and all that stuff. And we're on a health and wellness show.
Yep.
And you know what that brings me to? Our first sponsor.
He didn't find the Godiva.
Yes.
I didn't find that.
Godiva?
And that air first sponsor is NeoZoe Health and Wellness Center in Cranford, New Jersey.
Yay.
It's a very unique holistic wellness company recognizing the interconnection of body, mind, spirit, and the importance of creating complete wellness in a nurturing and comforting environment. NeoZoe, creating new life through balanced living using nutrition, massage, and so much more. And the month of April is called the Fresh Start Month. What is that? Nutritional consultations, where if you call for one for a brand new start, does not mean that you're going on a diet. It means how we can help you change your lifestyles or find out what might be good and what might not be so good. Got that, gentlemen?
Why are you looking at me?
Well, because I see those munchkins in front of you. Everything in moderation. And if you go ahead and you go call for an appointment this month and come, you'll get $10 off your consultation fee. Yes. So again, it's NeoZoe Health and Wellness Center. It is creating comfort for you. For the summer's right around the corner. Why not start now? And you could visit them on the web at www.neozoe. That's NEOSZOE.com or call them at 732-713-0123. And also, they have a birthday club. Many people have taken advantage of this. If you sign up with the birthday club and you show proper identification of your birthday month, you will receive $10 off of any service the entire month that you, if you want to make two massages, three massages, a nutrition consult, whatever you want to do, you get $10 off every single session during your birthday month. So again, visit them on the web, www.neozoe.com, or call them at 732-713-0123. Get your fresh start today. You're calling, right, tomorrow?
Sure.
He's like, fetch it.
I do things in moderation. I eat like a box at a time.
Is that 25, 50?
Not when I'm around. You eat half a box at a time.
That's still 25 because that thing says 50 on the side.
I know, but they didn't have 25 boxes.
Oh, okay. All right. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Okay. I can't see what's in the box, so I'm going to have to take him at face value.
No, I remember he was saying that when we walked in. It was a low count.
It was a low count.
Because don't be deceived by the box count.
Oh, okay.
And they're all powdered sugar.
Wonderful. So our musical director can fly high on sugar.
Oh, yeah.
I try to do that every day so you can have them all sugared up for the ride home.
That's wonderful. Nice.
Wonderful.
I'm so considerate.
Yes, I know. Thank you. Because then that'll wire them up for the show. And then later on, if everybody stays tuned, you know, there'll be a sing-along. And by that point, I'm sure he'll be playing like something fast, you know. Just watch.
Or he'll play the song fast.
And he'll just wait. So again, we are here with tonight's guest on the Health and Wellness Show on COARadio.com. And you can join our special guest, Wanda Ellett from G45 Consulting and so much more at 609-241-7103 and joining our conversation. So I have a question for you. You serve Wall Street Financial Services as a sourcing executive.
Yeah.
Okay. And the world economy we were just discussing and the way we do business has changed so much.
Yeah.
So how has that impacted these sectors in the workforce? Like people that come to you looking for this type of work and just say at the time, I don't know what it is now. You would know better than I about what jobs are available and all. Is it coming back to where it was or just...
I think it's changed somewhat. Like I said, you know, sometimes some of these organizations, they're looking for people that are... it's a morphed position because, you know, Sally and Joe were gone and now we have Paul who is doing three jobs and they were very disparate. So sometimes, but they're easing back away from that a little bit more because they're realizing they can't really do that. Also, there's the advent of artificial intelligence, you know, the impact of AI. And, you know, on my show, my brother would actually do the show with me, and we talked a lot. He would come on and talk about tech topics. Oh. So we had a number of different topics, you know, the different shows on this, on artificial intelligence. And we talked about, is a robot going to take my job?
Right.
And, you know, there is somewhat of a trend, even in some of the office aspects. Sprint has Pepper, I think the name of that, the robot.
Yeah.
And, you know, people don't realize the impact of that and how you have to morph yourself and how you have to address, you know, some of these changes and how to adopt them. Some people will come in and still want to do a job that isn't really relevant anymore and not really, you know, not that you can't find that job, but it's really not paying. I think also with the economic landscape today, a lot of people that were making a certain salary back in the day, right now they may be stitching that together. It may be a quilting kind of situation mm-hmm. where they're doing three and four jobs to still maintain that salary or even a little bit less. And that's very commonplace. You know, like people that they've, you know, even on the show, I've interviewed people that were, you know, also on Wall Street and they lost their jobs and decide, what am I going to do now? And, you know, it's been very common that has happened, that, well, you know, people have to change. You have to morph. You have to, you know, adapt to what you
have. You have to reinvent yourself.
Well, that's the thing. And beside reinventing yourself, because we're here at City of Angels and it's about mm-hmm. addiction and recovery and things like that. And one thing we discuss a lot, and I don't know your views on this, and I don't mean to put you on the spot, but I'm kind of putting you on the spot here, is that when people have these unfortunate circumstances, whether they had surgeries, got hooked on opioid addiction and all, and New Jersey is really suffering bad with the opioid addiction mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. it's becoming very prominent. So somebody, you know, has their problems, they go in recovery, and now they're thrown out of this recovery center to turn around and say, okay, you're expected to get a job. You're expected to, you know, do everything you're supposed to do. But companies, you put on that application that you, you know, if they were convicted of something or whatever, how does somebody in that position kind of start over? Like, do you have any guidance? Like, they might not even know, like, what do I put on my resume, or how do I fill out that job application, or, you know, what do I do?
With any of it, because, like, a big challenge people face, too, is ageism and some prejudice, because as you're getting older, you know, people don't necessarily want to pay the salary or even pay for your experience. And one of the things that I do share with that is, you know, be honest. So whether you're talking about whatever it is, you know, moms, if they had to step away, mommy track.
Right.
You know, it's a similar kind of thing. Just be honest. And you know, some people get upset, too, because they didn't get this dream job with this company. I applied, and it looked so great.
Yeah.
But you're not supposed to be there. And it's putting you closer to your yes. And, you know, you have to take a step back. And through any of these challenges, really take the step back and evaluate, what are my assets today? What can I do? Mm-hmm. And ask yourself, what can I do today? And bit by bit, you're going to get there and get where you want to go. And think about, where do I want to be? And just be honest. Mm-hmm. And you know, I can't tell you, I cover the career fair at Ryder University.
Oh,
you know,
okay.
The radio show is at Ryder University Sunday mornings. And as part of covering, of doing the radio show, I cover the career fair. And I have to say, you know, because I've asked some people, like even on this side, like not on here, but I ask them, like, what if somebody, you know, because we've talked about this, because the drug problem is so prevalent, and, you know, it's heartbreaking, you know, to hear friends that their kids are dying, you know, and it's just, it's crazy. And it's not like the kid was in some bad family or bad situation. They have a great parent. I know their parents. You know what I mean?
Right.
And it was just like, you know, they may have been hurt in sports, and then they ended up getting, you know, into a little situation, and, you know, they got addicted to the pain pills, and it's just like, it just
happens,
you know? But in some of these constant conversations I've had with people, it's be honest, be yourself. And the right company, the right opportunity is going to present itself. Think about your own gifts and your own passion. What's your what are you about? What's your what song do you have to sing? What's your gift that you have to share with the world? And how are you going to go there? And how are you going to get there? Some of it may be passion, and sometimes you may have to find passion in just doing ordinary things until you get where you need to go.
And that's really great advice, because I think too, because there's such a stigma, you know, mm-hmm. with people in recovery and
there's
things like that.
There's a stigma with everything.
But, you know, this is true. You're very, that's correct.
Most people are going to be prejudiced because of the mommy track. She thinks she is. She's going to come back in here. She was doing that before. You didn't lose your skills.
Yeah, you gained them as you become a mother. I hate to tell you.
Yeah. You know what I mean? You didn't lose any skills being on the mommy track.
No, you didn't. And I think,
and even, I hate to say it, like, even doing, like, you know, it sounds terrible, but you know, especially being in recovery through those programs, they give you so much. You're doing a lot of soul searching.
Exactly. And that's what I'm saying. Like, you said something very key, you know, just be honest. And that's being honest with yourself too. Just say, okay, I had a little hiccup along the road. It's just a little stumble. Let me get back up and pull myself together, and life goes on. And to your point, if the company wants you, they'll find the right company for you when it's meant to be. And I think that's the best thing you could say, instead of people getting down on themselves, wow, nobody wants me now because of this. Nobody wants me. And I think that's where people go, more like the victim mode, you know? And instead, you're
that's
saying,
useless. That's like,
exactly. You know. And you're saying, you know, just be honest with them, with yourself, and just keep going. Don't ever get discouraged, because you'll find the right company.
Yeah, and the right company's out there for you. You just got to keep going. And then in hindsight, once you reach where you're supposed to be and everything's flowing, you'll say, oh my God, thank God I didn't go to the other company. You know, and I have to say, like, even like, you know, it was interesting, because if you think about it, you know, this question comes up sometimes with people, whether they're, you know, transitioning, you know, in you know, with everything with the genders, you know, some people feel prejudiced because of their sexuality,
right?
You know, and you know, a company, and I have to say, like a company like JP Morgan, I was very impressed, because they were very supportive of a number of different, like, situations,
right?
You know, and whether it was sexuality, even, like, you know, there were people there who had experiences with, you know, with drugs and alcohol.
Okay.
And there was a lot of support. We have a caller.
Yes, we do. We do. And we do have a caller, and you are calling the Health and Wellness Show. I'm Maryann Castello, your host, and you are live on the air. Who am I speaking with?
You know, I must have called a couple of days too early because I was looking to congratulate Coleman on 10 years of debauchery. But I guess I called the wrong show. I must be a little mixed up.
Oh, George, are you trying to do something with your health instead?
I'm not healthy. But I know Coleman isn't healthy either because I've been looking at pictures of him lately. He looks like he's red in the head. He's got a lot of beeps going on his face like he's been one of those balls that people kick on the field. He's looking a little weak. But you know, I don't mean to be hassling you about Danny Coleman, but I do want to say one thing.
Yes?
I'm Kenny Siegel.
What? Now we saw to Kenny Siegel. Yeah, George?
He's gone.
He's gone. George just is a fan, used to be the co-host with Danny Coleman on Rock On Radio, and he used to call the show all the time and kind of razz on Danny. And then he hasn't called. We haven't heard from him in months, and last month was the first time George revealed himself on the show, and this was our second time.
He resurfaced. I don't want him to reveal himself.
Well, George, I hope you are healthy, and if you are not, by all means, reach out. But know that we love you, George. You always have a home here.
He sounds healthy.
He doesn't sound healthy.
Coleman's head looks like a red football. What did he say? What did he say? Looks like his head's been kicked around.
Something like a soccer ball.
I think he called the pork rind power hour, not the health and wellness show.
Oh, that's funny. Our audience member John speaks up.
Johnny,
I love it.
Johnny in the shadows.
Well, that is great. Well. Going back to our conversation.
I miss George.
That's okay, but this leads us to our next sponsor. Okay, and this
You want music for this?
Sure, that would be great. And talking about careers and recovery, this is City of Angels. And if you or a loved one are conquering an addiction and you need to conquer that addiction, City of Angels is here to always help. And if you or a loved one is struggling with addiction, help is always available. You can call City of Angels at 609-910-4942. And you could also visit them on the web at www.cityofangelsnj.org. And if you go there and you click the donation tab, you can enter any denomination. And in the special instructions, if you put donation for Health and Wellness Show, we'll make you an official sponsor for the show for 30 days. No denomination is too small. Just remember that, because City of Angels runs 100% on all donations to help everyone. So again, if you or a loved one is really struggling with addiction, help is always available. Never be ashamed. It is a problem that you can get help with, and it can be resolved. Don't be discouraged. Don't be afraid. Call City of Angels at 609-910-4942. Hope is always available. Thank you. So I just wanted to get that out.
Do we clap after that?
You're welcome.
Well, you can if you want.
Yep. Johnny and I are the youngest. Clamping for our sponsors.
Well, here's the thing. So
thanks, Johnny.
I know that you have a secret.
Yes.
You have a secret.
Yes, I do.
And I wanted you to share your secret on the show. And I heard through the grapevine that you have something called the Secret Mentor Society.
Yes, I do.
I have no idea what that is, but I want to know how I could become a member where it's not a secret.
Okay, so the Secret Mentor Society, it was kind of funny because it's kind of like a, it's not a joke, but like as far as the name, I came up with it because it's a Secret Mentor Society because it's supposed to be the worst kept secret eventually. And that's honestly like how I named it. So anyway, but the Secret Mentor Society is basically a call to action for people to improve their professionalism. Now with the advent of social media becoming so prevalent, and at the time, like when I created this, it wasn't as prevalent as it is today, and people weren't just showing bad behavior instantaneously on Facebook and things like that, and Instagram didn't even exist. And it's basically, you know, people will highlight bad things. So you never know who's watching you, good or bad. And so it's basically a call for people to be your best version of yourself and to always conduct yourself as your best self, to learn, to grow, to be better, and to do better. because you could be mentoring somebody, you know. And that's another thing too, because some people, so many people are like, oh, I want a mentor, but they don't necessarily want to go through the work to, you know, create a program, and, you know, and it's a lot of work on both sides for a mentor and for a mentee.
Right. Absolutely.
You know, like, it's a big time commitment. It can be a big time commitment. It can be a big, you know, just a lot of things involved in it, and even setting up the process. So it's difficult as an adult, especially, to find a mentor. And I feel you can find mentors, and you can be a mentor and not even realize it. And that's why it's kind of, you're a secret mentor. Right. You know, it's like a secret crush. You know, somebody may not even know that they're your secret crush. You know what I mean? But, you know, in the same token, you could be somebody inspiring somebody by your actions. And character, to me, character is what you do when, you know, nobody's watching.
Absolutely.
You know? And that's like the true testimony of like who you are and what you are. And with everything that's bad in the world, I think it's just a call to be better and do better.
Well, I think too, you say, you know, being a mentor and a mentee, if you doing this, you, somebody wants to better themselves. They want to learn something, a skill, you right. know, a mindset that they never really had before. Right. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, you're here to help people, but they have to help themselves too.
Yeah.
And I think in some level, some of us could be a little lazy, or mm-hmm. if you can procrastinate procrastination, you're looking at the queen of it. I could tell you that. If things I don't want to do, let me yeah. rephrase that.
Exactly.
But in order to get yourself better and be the best version of you that you just said, you have to work at it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So let me ask you, if somebody comes to your secret mentor society, okay, and you start working with them, but you see them kind of falling short of the mark. They're not holding up their end of the bargain, because it's kind of a bargaining thing. How do you handle that?
Well, there's a couple things here. The Secret Mentor Society, eventually, like, and granted, like, within the next month, it'll be revealed more. If you go to my website, G45 Consulting, click on Secret Mentor Society, you'll see.
It's a secret.
It's a secret right now. But eventually, my thoughts were, it's kind of networking, you know, connect. Network the network groups,
right?
And it gives you another opportunity to network into different opportunities to guide you and to show you, you know, as a central place where you can find out, like, if I'm gonna, you know, where can I find out more information about a professional organization that I'm interested mm-hmm. in? So, you know, it would kind of, if this company, not company, but this network group would be interested in being part of the Secret Mentor Society and tagged on our website, then they could, you know, you can kind of have an introduction in saying, you know, you may know somebody, and it may give you another tag on LinkedIn to kind of connect. Mm-hmm. And it's just, you know, and that's what it's all about. It's all about relationships, and, you know, it's not necessarily who you know. Some of it is who knows you, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And just like, you know, even with the event, like how we met and how we're here today.
I was just thinking
you
that.
Know, it's just like, it's
serendipitous.
Yeah, it's just, you know, we're all here. None of us are getting out alive.
No.
Well, through networking, through that, yeah. that's what it's all about, right?
Yeah, and that's the thing, like with the Secret Mentor Society, the vision is eventually, you know, we may have like annual meetings or semi-annual, and it could be bi-coastal, it could just be a Google Hangout, and it could be just an opportunity for all different professions and all different people just to get together and network and try to be better. And there may be the theme where, like this year on Your Career is Calling, it's overcoming obstacles. So a theme for, you know, Secret Mentor Society was like, you know, as far as mentoring, like how can I be better and how can I learn to overcome an obstacle? And it's tied back to the radio show as right. far as, you know, week to week you have a story and you can listen to the podcast to, you know, hear like, how can I overcome an obstacle? How can I be better? And this person did it and how did they do it? And, you know, and that's, so it's kind of tied together.
It's important. That's, yeah. that's important stuff.
Yeah. And the other thing we have is the Secret Mentor Society Boot Camp. And what that is a 10-day
boot camp. Got boot my camp. Interest.
It's a boot camp.
Sounds like a competition.
Well, it's kind of competition because it kind of you're in the bunker, you Uh-oh. Know, and with a group of people. It's a 10-day class, and every day for 2 weeks, you know, every weekday for 2 weeks, you're in the bunker with, you know, your fellow.
It's like the recovery coach again. Yeah.
I was just thinking that.
Yeah. You're there, and you're going. We talk about different topics, you know. And there, it's more like traditional. I'm also starting to put one together for business owners versus just people that are looking for a different opportunity, another job, but also for people who are looking to increase their business. And, you know, it's the same kind of principles, whether it's not necessarily your resume, but what's your, you know, what's your brochure look like? How are you networking? How are you connecting? Do you know what your client is? Who's your target client?
That's a great idea, because when you bring people together that way, mm-hmm. number one, like you said, recovery coach, number one, all different walks of life, but when you leave, you're all great friends. You have that.
You're in that same
You're
hell.
In that thing.
You know,
well, I
you're
know.
In the bunker.
Yes, but
it creates that bond.
Yep. Yeah, yeah, yep. No doubt.
Do you have a dress code of fatigues to attend this boot
no.
camp?
No.
See? Birthday Mine would be suits. Pink, white, and gray.
Well, actually, most people are in their pajamas.
Bunny pajamas, slippers, too?
Yeah, no, there was. They're in sweats or, you know, T-shirts because they're on the phone. And, you know, it's just, you know, we do it on, you know, it's a conference call. So it's a video thing. So nobody really dresses. I just hope they're wearing pants.
You'll never know.
Don't get on the camera. Don't stand up.
Like that one commercial. There's like one commercial where the guy's like, you know, interviewing, or he's with his group chat with his coworkers, and then he stands up and he has boxers on, and it's just like everybody's like,
at least he had boxers on. It could have been worse.
Yeah, he had a suit jacket and a tie and everything, and then he had his boxers. He had no pants.
I
Put
love
your pants
it.
On. You know, no, but that's a secret mentor. So every, you know. It's and it has helped people because, you know, you're talking, you're the CEO of Me Inc., you know, and managing
right.
your career. And that's what we talked about too on the radio show. And it's you're commiserating with others, like the kind of, you know, like you're saying with the recovery coach, you know, like you're commiserating with people. They get it. They know your struggles. They know your pain. If you talk to your spouse, you talk to your brother, you talk to your aunt, you talk to your mother, everybody's like, well, why aren't you doing this? Why aren't you doing that? And you get defensive versus mm-hmm. somebody else is like,
everyone has an opinion.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
We also have something else, yeah. all of us.
I wasn't going to go there.
But I did.
It is true, though. You know, but if somebody else in the group says that to you, well, why don't you try this? I don't know why, but it just comes across different.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because they're coming to you from a humble place, maybe. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And it's not judged. You know, you're not being judged.
Coming from your family's total judgment.
It's just kind of like, you know. You know, stab. Why are you doing this? You know, but it's not really bad. It's, you know, it's from love and concern, and you know, they want to know because they're vested into your career as well.
Absolutely.
And it impacts them as well because they don't want to see you hurting. They don't want to see you sad. They don't want to see you like in front of a computer, like, you know, pumping out these resumes into the black hole. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't want to see you doing that.
You know what I hate about resumes?
What?
That they expect you to put your whole life on one page.
Actually, they don't.
No more?
No.
I could send in a novel?
You could send in a novel. But no, but you know what happens too? Some people, they put, it's a manifesto, and this is my resume, and it's a gold, and do not touch it and edit it.
Right.
You know, and if you try to help somebody, like, change their resume, it's a pain. But you really should have multiple versions of your resume,
mm-hmm.
and it should be targeted to whatever the position is. You know, it should be... And you should also, I'll give you some of the wisdom, you know, is every time you go sit to submit to a resume for a position, you should actually be putting together your value package. And your value package should consist of your resume and a targeted resume and also a targeted cover letter, what I call a T-letter.
Mm-hmm.
So it matches the position. You take the highlights and what, you know, things, you know, what you've done. The high-level things that are very critical to them, and how you match that position to a T. And then it's like a teaser saying, look, you know, I can come in and I can do this, that, and the other thing for you, and I'm a success, and let's have a further conversation. I'd like to discuss this further with you. And then the next step is you're going to contact, and these are things we go through in the boot camp.
Mm-hmm.
Next thing, we're going to contact, look for somebody you're connected to on LinkedIn, you know, in this company. And then you're going to contact this person, and you're going to arm them. It's not like, hey, help me find a job.
Right.
You're going to help them to help you.
Okay, go. Okay,
you know?
That's different.
So you're going to say, hey, you know, I see this position out there. What can you tell me about the hiring manager? What can you tell me about the company? Do you like working there? Because you have to remember, you're looking for a company. You're looking for a home. And you want to make sure you're interviewing them just as much as they're interviewing you. Are you going to be a fit? Are you going to be happy there? Is it something you're going to be walking into a beep story show? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Now, granted, every company...
Sugar, honey, iced tea. I know where you're going.
You know, but you want to know, like, is this somebody that I would get along with, the boss?
See, I always said it. My boss at my last job always said, oh, I hired this great guy. He's going to be awesome for you. And I'd be like, time will tell.
Yeah.
Because as soon as somebody gets comfortable, you know what I mean? You're going to see the real
colors.
You know? Yes. I mean, you're going to see who they really are, you know, and
you've
sometimes
done that.
That's
with
wonderful.
I was
going to
say,
so
you've
much
done that with Richie and myself, and 2.5 years later, here we still are.
I've done that with a lot of people.
No, but it's true, and that's why you have to be honest.
Because you're awesome.
You know, because you are, you know, you're going to be you. Eventually, it's going to come
eventually
out.
Eventually, it's going to come out, and that's a true. I tell my daughters the same thing. I'm like, and time will tell. You know what I mean? Oh, I love this guy. He's great. I said, time will tell. You know what I mean? As soon as he gets comfortable with you, we'll see if he still treats you with respect and, you know, and all that. Mm. Goes all the way across the board.
Yes, yeah, it does. Now, your company, G45 Consulting, provides professional services, and you cover many areas of service. Like when I was looking at it, you have technology, products, and maintenance. You have management and consulting services. I love the word talent just because of what I'm into. Talent acquisition and management and translation interpretation services. So when people contact you, can they pick and choose services? Do you package them together?
Well, it depends. And that's where, like...
Or do you determine by their needs what's best for them?
Well, basically, you know, with the advent, everything's gluttonous on the internet anymore. So nobody's really just going to go onto your menu of services in the internet. And there again, it's networking. It's, you know, it's basically solicitation. Nobody's going to come knocking at your door and just say, oh my God, you have the best website. It would be wonderful if that happened.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
That never happens.
And, you know, and it was interesting because like a couple of weeks ago on the show, actually, this past week, I had this doctor that I met through the internet, through Instagram, Dr. Ed Granite. And it was interesting talking to him. I enjoy his Instagram anyway, because he talks about health and he's just always talking to you. But one of the things that he mentioned was, he became a doctor. And he didn't know what he was going to be. And he decided he was going to be a chiropractor because one of his friends said, you know, he was going to be a chiropractor and this is what you had to do to be a chiropractor. And he was like, oh, that sounds like a great idea. But it was interesting in how his approach was with, you know, it's not like the old school model where, you know, you had a doctor in the town and everybody would go to the doctor. Or there's just so much competition. There's just so many things and you have to differentiate yourself. And there again, that's why I'm interested in doing this boot camp for business owners as well, because you have to go out and solicit, you know.
Absolutely.
And then in talking to them, then you can identify, like when I'm talking to these clients, you know, how can I serve you? Or if I hear through the grapevine, I've networked with somebody who says they're looking for some help with their recruiting, or you know, a certain manager within a company, you know, they need help with technology services, or the lawyer in this organization, you know, they need help with sourcing, or the accountant. Like let's talk about different things. Plus, I've networked with a number of different, you know, CX, what they call CXO, so they're CFO, CPO, CISO, you know, and. And they, you know, sitting on the beach, they're retired, and they're like, get me out of my house. Put me to work, Wanda.
Well, speaking of putting people to work, we have our next sponsor, and it is our very own Rich Chlanda and Flying Dreams, which is a progressive rock band featuring world-renowned musicians Rich Chlanda, who has been one of the original founders of Fire Ballet, was previously with Nectar and now currently with Nectar, and did several tours with Renaissance and many other things, and his new project, Flying Dreams. You also have Ron Beanstock, who's probably one of the top intellectual property attorneys as well as a bass player, and is also known to have on his roster Stephen Wilson, Dream Theater, but he's also played with many famous
people.
It's
good to have your attorney as your bass player.
And we also have Kendall Scott,
Keep them close. Now.
Kendall Scott is a legend of his own kind, coming into his own self by being a keyboard player and also originally now, actually formerly currently, with Nectar. That's something new in the last month or so, but also known from Project Object, which is a Zappert featured band, and our drummer, Mr. J. Didimo, and he was also Zappa, and he plays with all kinds of music as well. So you have a great band there with Rich Chlanda, Ron Beanstalk, Kendall Scott, and J. Didimo. And if you want to see where their next shows are, where they're touring, you can do that by visiting their website. It's www.richchlanda, and I'll spell that for you. It is RycheChlanda, flyingdreams.com. Again, it's www.richchlandaflyingdreams.com to find out all of their information. And you have so much coming up, I'm sure.
Yep.
You can't leave a guitar in his hand. Do you see if you leave a guitar in his hand, he just goes off in La La Land once he starts playing?
He's like in heaven. No. You're in heaven.
He is. He
just, I never thought that.
Well, he just like transposed somewhere that I have no idea where he just went. Oh, but speaking of that, we have an event for City of Angels.
We do?
Yes, you do. On Saturday, this is quite exciting, actually. Saturday, May 18th at 7 p.m., City of Angels and the COA Angels baseball team presents Strikeout Substance Misuse, a drug prevention and recovery night with a night of baseball. Trenton Thunder versus Binghamton Rumble Ponies. It will take place at the Arm and Hammer Park. That's at One Thunder Road in Trenton, New Jersey. And there'll be prevention and recovery resources available, free giveaways, raffles, a 50-50, fireworks, and most of all, baseball. Who doesn't like baseball? And tickets are available from City of Angels volunteers, or you can purchase your tickets on the City of Angels website at www.cityofangelsnj.org/event. If you purchase your tickets online, you may pick them up at the will call window at the Arm and Hammer Park the night of the event. And if you have any questions or comments with regards to this event, you could send an email to info@cityofangelsnj.org. So you're going to have fun, educational, and fun night of baseball. Purchase your tickets today at www.cityofangelsnj.org/event.
I have like 400 tickets home, so.
How much are they?
They're $11. Wow. It's fireworks night, and we're the recipients of the 50-50 that night as well.
Wow. That's big stuff.
Yeah, it's good.
And Trenton Thunder.
We've been after the Trenton Thunder for a long time because they hold breast cancer awareness night and autism night and, you know, all great causes. But we were like, when can we have a recovery night? And they finally got to it this year. So
that's great. Wow. That's great, Art.
That is awesome.
And that's a fun night. It sounds like a fun night. Yeah, it's like everything.
We have a pig roast coming up, too. June 23rd, I believe. I don't have all the details on that yet.
A pig roast.
Yeah. Here, right here in downtown Hightstown.
Oh, yeah?
A pig.
Out back. Remember where we did the open house last year?
Yeah.
Where we're going to be doing
a pig. A P-I-G. A pretty, intelligent girl.
I'm looking for entertainment.
Well, it could be it could be me and Mad Dog Lopez again.
Actually, Vinny's in Florida right now, but I was going to reach out to him to see if he was going to be up here and see if
they wanted to play. How much is a pig roast?
I'm not sure yet. I think it was $20 for everything for the whole.
Wow, that's good. Good price.
But I wanted to get some good entertainment, so people have a reason to want to come.
I think he's dropping you a hint, if there ever was one, right in front of me.
I'll do it if Vinny does it. Vinny was the original drummer from Springsteen.
Yes, right? He was.
So, wow.
He's a great guy. He's wonderful.
He's funny, man. He was just he's someplace in Florida.
He's funny. He's right caddying. He's doing a caddy thing probably.
Well, no, he's playing
like
around.
He does that too.
Really? That's pretty funny.
Actually, he's always been a golf caddy. He's always been a golf caddy.
Talk about living your passion, like doing, you know, like working your passion.
Oh, yeah. No, he just was inducted.
Stitching stuff together. Yeah.
He just inducted
the
Hall
of Fame. He's not a caddy. He's probably like that gopher.
No, he is a caddy, man. I mean, he is actually a very good one. He goes with the pros. I mean, I forget the guy's name. It's Mark something. He's from here in Jersey, down around the Asbury Park area.
Yeah.
Caddies make cash.
He makes
yes.
He's been that his whole life. You know?
And caddies make dynamite for little gophers.
Vinny's actually a good golfer, too.
Little gopher.
But that was my thought, was to see if Vinny was available. You know what I mean? To see.
Oh, yeah.
And the Winos.
Oh, no, they're a great band. They're great. They were fun.
Have you seen them? Oh,
that's
yeah,
the name
that's
of the
right.
I saw him at Rock Fest.
It's Vinny Lopez featuring the wonderful Winos.
I saw him at Rock
Fest. That's pretty funny.
We hung out after Rock Fest.
Yeah, they're a great bunch of guys, man. Actually, his guitar player's in the Blues Hall of Fame.
I know he is.
Really?
Yes.
That's pretty wacky.
Well, you know, so they were concerned about me because I was running across.
They were concerned about you.
I was running across.
Don't let that get out.
When you're running, we always get concerned.
Well, I was running. No, I was. And I tripped over a wire and I fell right on my face because I had two guitars in my hands.
At Rockfest.
And I wanted to save my guitar. So I said, and I went splat on my face. And they all
blood
came to me and
coming
said,
out
blood.
Everywhere.
Dude, are you okay?
The guitars. How were they?
I saved the guitars.
He did save the guitars. But you know what that means?
Another sponsor?
No.
Oh.
That when you hold this and you say, I got it, you got it. So you know what?
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
Yeah, you caught it. It's time for our health and wellness sing-along. And why not do a little You Got It from Orbison? Ladies and gentlemen, join Wanda, John, myself, Maryann, Richie, and Art in our sing-along tonight. You got it. Are you ready, Wanda?
Oh, my God.
Here we go.
Every time I look into your lovely eye, I see a love that money just can't buy.
Here we go.
One look from you, I drift away. I pray that you are here.
Thank you, Wanda and John. I hear you back there.
I'm waiting for the Roy Orbison hologram tour.
I absolutely love it.
Wow. Okay.
You did great.
Okay.
That was awesome.
God, that was fun. That just woke me up. And you know what that means? We're going on to our next sponsor. Why not? This is wonderful.
You want music?
Yes, okay. Because you could sing You Got It to yourself and listen to Roy Orbison right on your very high-tech low buds. High-tech low buds, safety and sound, high-performance audio for outdoor joggers, bicycling, and all sports. High-tech brand of earphones are designed and manufactured with electroglow-luminescence technology. Glowbud earphones emit a safe and bright neon light that with the touch of a button will flicker neon lighting along to your favorite tunes, like You Got It. In addition, for an enhanced audio experience, they added in high-performance studio drivers designed to their specification for churning out amazingly clear and vibrant highs and bottoms to create one of the best sports earphones for indoor and outdoor use, day or night, on the market today. Now you can feel safe at night with enhanced visibility for walking and talking, jogging and being seen by street traffic wearing their Sports Talk Glow Buds. Hear and see the difference. You can get your pair today through their distributor website, www.whatsonsale. That's WATTSonsale.com. Get your pair today. High tech Glow Buds. And you could listen to our sing-along. I loved it. Thank you, High Tech.
Yay!
And if you call the show at 609-241-7103, and you've not won these yet, we will send a pair to you. So 609-241-7103.
Have you tried those things?
I have.
They're great. They're really cool.
When they were in the studio, I got a pair.
They're great.
Yes, and tonight we are here on the Health and Wellness Show on COARadio.com. Absolutely. With our very special guest, who is waving her magic wand again, Wanda Ellett. I absolutely love it. And we've been talking about G45 Consulting Company that you are the CEO and founder of. But I also know that we found out in the studio, thank you for singing along too, that Wanda not only has a big personality,
but she's got
the gift of gab.
Yep.
So that's why not have your own radio show if you have the gift of gab. And it's called Your Career is Calling. So how did you develop the show and how did you start your gift of gab on that show?
So I've been doing the show for about 6 years now, and I didn't...
6 years, that's great.
Yeah,
that's
a lot of fun. The show has been on for about...
And she's still talking 6 years later now. Yeah. Couldn't help myself.
Still talking. The show has been on for about, I think it's been 9 years. And, let me think. It's 8 years it's been on. And it originally started as an extension of a network group called the Breakfast Club.
Okay.
That meets in East Brunswick. And, it was actually around the time that the Oprah show was still on, and they were doing auditions for the Oprah show. Like, you have your own show.
Right.
So I made this audition. It was terrible. You can see it if you Google me. It's terrible. It's horrible. It's hard, but it's funny.
Everybody Google her now.
Yeah, it's kind of funny. Wanda Ellett, or I think it was Wanda McGarrow, Oprah audition. So then I was in this network group, and they were saying, they needed another venue or another opportunity for people to reach out. If you're in transition and looking for a job, like, what can you do? And, they had this network group that meets, it's the second Saturday of every month, and... I think it's the Days Inn on 18. So they were thinking, different things. Facebook groups were starting and stuff back then. And, when I did this thing for the radio show, for the Oprah show, then they were saying, why don't we do a TV show or even a radio show? And one of the members, he's one of the founders of the Breakfast Club, he was an alumni of Rider University. So him and this other guy... they went, he went to Ryder and, organized everything. They did the show for about a year together.
Mm-hmm.
And then he dropped out, the one guy, Rod. And then Frank was my co-host when, he asked me, he goes, do you want to do the show with me? Because it was right around the time that I started doing my company. And I was doing recruiting and career coaching. And I was like, oh, my God, this is a perfect opportunity. I'm really honored. Thank you very much. And And then we started doing the show. We did the show for about a year and a half, 2 years together. And then, you know, for the last years, I've been doing it on my own. You know, he had some health challenges and decided he needed to take, you know, step away from it. And you know, the station manager asked me, he goes, do you want to do it? You know, you want to keep doing it by yourself? And I was like, yeah, why not? And he loved, you know, they loved the work that I did. And that's how it started.
It's like, do you want to talk to the man in charge or to the woman who knows what's really going on?
Amen, sister.
What was
true, true statement.
So it was fun, you know, and I've always had a lot of fun with it. And initially, what we did on the show was every month, every week, it's a live call-in show. And every week we would have, like, initially we would just have random topics and things. Then when I started doing the show on my own, I said that I wanted to have standard high-level topics like networking, interviewing. Like, over the years, I did... you know, just dealing with different aspects of your career, like elder care, you know, family crisis. We had, I can't even tell you some of the guests I've had on. I've had somebody on that Sidekicks Respite Care. They were on, he's been on probably the most. I met him through the career fair at Ryder. And what they do is, it's not, they do, they deal with families with autism, the children that are on the spectrum, and they work in the house with, you know, each with the families to help their child improve, and whatever it is, they tailor it to that their needs, and they develop a program and work with each of the children. It's interesting because, you know, he was a young man, and to watch him grow his business and grow, and I think he just got married like a year or two ago, so it's exciting to see that. Actually, in the next couple of weeks, this week's Easter, so we're not going to have a live show, but the week following, my first producer's coming back onto the radio show. I'm going to interview him. He's currently at CBS Radio, and he's a producer there on one of the sports shows, and I apologize. I'm drawing a blank on the name of the show, but my producers now, and they're student producers, so it gives the kids the opportunity, and I'm sorry I say kids, the young adults, you know, and the students in the university, the opportunity to do a hands-on live show, so they get great experience.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and then, and it's just the station manager, he was actually John Moses. He was actually a co-host, I don't know what it was, a Philly radio station. I'm a North Jersey girl, so I don't really know like Philly stuff. I'm sorry, but he was very popular. He's like the Z100 guy for many years. He was down here in the Philly area, and you know, so he's very well known. Like, you know, when we're the New Jersey best college radio station in New Jersey, and with the New Jersey Broadcasters Association, and he had all the different the hosts from the different talk shows go to the Broadcasters Association, you know, because when we won this award, you know, and because he didn't know we were up for the award, and it was exciting because, like, I'm checking in and people knew him, you know, they were like, oh, where are you checking in from? And I was like, I'm with the Bronc, and they were like, oh, that's John Moses. You know? It was just like an old, like, they're talking to each other, you know, like making a big deal about it. And I was just like, John, I guess you're a big deal. You know what I mean? Like, you know, and he's like, yeah, I am. And it was... he was pissed at me. So anyway, but he's always pissed at me for something. But anyway, but he holds everybody at a high standard, you know, and that's one of the things, like with the young adults, the students, they, when they leave the organization, when they leave this experience, they are welcome into CBS Radio.
Oh,
into,
wow. Okay.
You know, Jake, the producer, he's a Ryder alum. He's on Z100
in the
morning.
I know who he is, yes.
Yeah, he was a Ryder alum. And like I said, Stu Kovacs, that was my first producer. And this he was just like, I hate this comic, but he was just so wonderful. Like, as, you know, I remember, like, he was the producer for quite a while, and he would just go above and beyond. And he showed more professionalism than some people I know.
But you know what? It has to be a rewarding experience for you, because you get to see this young talent.
Yeah.
And they're helping you. Yeah, and while they're helping you, they're gaining the experience.
Yeah, someone, yeah.
And then you see them elevate to these, you know, top 40 stations in New York.
I'm really
excited. They're still not making any money.
It was exciting, you know, because I'm still friends with him on Facebook.
It's not the business it used to be. Yeah. I'm sorry.
But it was funny because I follow him on Instagram and Facebook, and he was at the all these March Madness games. And he was a Peter Luger, like, with right. CBS, yeah. You know what I mean? Because they were having dinner. And so it's exciting to see, like, these different things right. that they're doing. And, you know, as they grow in their career. And like you said, like, it's just exciting. And even, you know, some of the different producers I've had, some of the different interesting things that they've brought to the table. And just the passion. And it was funny, you know, I had one producer that was just horrific. And... she was just painful, and you know, I'm laughing because I'm like, oh my God, she's gonna be a great star one day, you know what I mean? And it's just gonna be like, you know, but they didn't understand too, you know, they didn't take the situation seriously. And granted, it's Sunday morning for a college kid,
dun, dun,
8 a.m. There's been kids I've
had
to wake
up. Did you just say 8 a.m.?
8 a.m.
on a Sunday morning,
these kids, and they have to be in the studio at 7:20. Mm. There's, you know. Think about that.
I did. That's why I'm just like,
You know, my brother, he did the show with
sounds like
for
the beer
while.
And cornflakes.
Yeah. No, but college. I have to say, all you know, the producers I've had, they've all been very, you know, they've all been bright eyed and bushy tailed. Like,
that's an opportunity.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, most of them have respected that it is a fantastic opportunity, and it was interesting because the one that comes to mind that was just miserable at the end. She was making the transition, and then we had some, I forget what the guest was, and then she realized, like, you know, the people, she doesn't know who I know.
Right.
She doesn't know who I don't know. You know what I mean? She doesn't know anything about me. And she was just, like, looking at this, like, why is she, you know, and then she, you know, she realized at the end that, you know, the opportunity that it was, and, you know, we start talking about some of these other producers and stuff. But I'm excited to have Stu come on to the show.
That'll
the
be 28th. Awesome. That's
yeah, because the other producers, I have...
Now, where can people tune in or listen to your show?
It's 1077thebronc.com, and that's 1077thebronc.com. Also, we have iPhone and Android apps, WRRC1, WRRC2. That's Whiskey Radio, Radio Charlie 1, Whiskey Radio, Radio Charlie 2. Or else, you know, and you can just, or even just look up Your Career is Calling. We also have the podcasts, and we have archives of the show. So,
is your brother on the show? His brother's on the show?
He had been on the show for a couple of years, and he would do technology topics. And, you know, it was fantastic having him on the show. I really enjoyed it. Yeah, he would do, like, and it was interesting, too. And I have to applaud him because I would let him do whatever topic he wanted on technology. And then the whole advent of artificial intelligence, then I start seeing it pop up everywhere. You know what I mean? Oh. So we were always in front of the curve of all these different things. Also, we talked about digital hoarding. Oh, yeah, that was a great topic. I think that was a great
hoarding topic. With a D.
He's correcting her.
That's what the show
you
was.
Gotta love your brother. Yeah, oh my God,
it was a great show. Like, the shows were great. If you can listen to our shows where it was me and my brother, I loved having him on the show because it was like you could tell his brother and sister. Because sometimes he'd be looking at me like, no, like just like your moment just now.
He's like, no. And you know what? Because he's so innovative back there. He doesn't talk much, but when he does.
And I haven't shut his mic off all night. I gave him the opportunity to speak up when he felt.
But that brings us to our next sponsor talking about innovating. It's the Recovery Spot, innovating recovery with cutting edge addiction treatment and outpatient recovery for drugs and alcohol, offering state-of-the-art medical approaches combined with personalized treatment. They are physician owned and operated by Dr. Mesh Sawney and Dr. Scott Bienenfeld. And the Recovery Spot, Innovating Recovery, has two locations. They have one in New York. You can visit them on the web at www.recoveryspotny.com. And now they're open in Malibu and San Diego, California. And you can visit them on the web at www.recoveryspotca.com. Recovery Spot, Innovating Recovery.
Malibu.
I could go to Malibu right now.
You're there in your mind.
Oh, I've been there. It's a virtual vacation for me. So speaking of altered reality, our guest here, Wanda Ellett.
Well, if I can close that too your career is calling. One of the things that I hope that what people get and the feedback that I do get that people get out of it is initially, like I said, we would do the first couple of years, it was all like high level topics of like interviewing, networking, resumes and all these things. And you can go on to 100 different shows on, you know, you can find that information all over the web. And last year, what we started to do was 52 career stories. And if you do hashtag 52 career stories, you know, you'll see that in 52 career stories this year, overcoming obstacles. And the reason I chose to change that format up was I think that the lesson is in the story. And then sometimes hearing other people's stories, like we talked about earlier in the show, that, you know, when you hear somebody else went through something, that, you know, then you can learn from that, you know, and I can say I
absolutely.
Hadn't, you know,
absolutely.
Yeah, it's, right. it's.
All right, yes, I mean.
That's oh, yeah, great. Absolutely.
You can learn from that. And speaking of story, okay, I can't hold myself
another back commercial?
Anymore. No.
Another commercial.
That our very own Wanda Ellett here, she's also an author, and you have a new book coming out titled Lucky Switch.
Yes.
And I have to ask. So what genre does your book fall into? Because the title seems like it could be a romance novel.
It's a romance. There's
oh, is
romance.
It?
There is romance in there. It's a historical, I call it historical fiction.
Okay.
And basically, it's about the morning of 9/11. It starts the morning of 9/11. There's an administrative assistant, Rachel. She's just miserable in her life. And she, you know, she's working for this woman, and she's basically the doppelganger. She's like, they're unbelievable how much they look alike. And this woman is uber rich, but uber nasty. And then the morning of 9/11, you know, she pulls up and, in coming out of the limo. And then she goes up, you know, starts berating her, saying, you know, where's my report? Where's this? Where, you know, I got to go leave for Paris and what's going on? And just like really berates her. They switch clothes. And she sends her off to pick up the dry cleaning, pick up the passport, and, you know, mm-hmm. get things done. And she goes, and be back here snappy by 10 o'clock, you know? So, and this is like 7:30 in the morning. 9/11 happens. They have their offices in mm-hmm. the World Trade Center. And everybody thinks the administrative assistant is the one that died.
Oh, that's cool.
In the building, not World Trade Center, but it's actually the boss. But as she was going down the elevator, she's just pissed, and she's just like, screw this, I'm going to take over, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just going to, you know, I'm sick of putting up with this, and blah, 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 blah. So she would pretend, and from time to time, she would pretend to be her boss, you know? So when she went down into the limo, she pretended to be the boss. She was in her clothes,
right?
You know? And the limo driver's looking like, what the heck? Like, you know, why didn't she call me and tell me that she was, Belinda's coming back down again, you know what I mean? Like, what the hell? And then, you know, and it continues from there.
That's really cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's been fun. It's been fun writing it, and it's just been, and she, you know, she goes to Paris and all
right.
this
stuff. Now, you have a teaser of the book out. The first chapter of the book is available, correct?
Yes. It's on WordPress. If you go to my Instagram is Wanda Ellett, WandaElett. And on there, I put it in there. Hang on, I'll tell you exactly where it is.
I love when they do it right on the show. It's great. It's like talk about instant gratification. Well, while she's doing that, she brought actually a picture frame that, you know, you can see on radio.
Yeah.
I love it.
You can see.
But she has a picture. Is that the book cover or what?
Yeah,
exactly?
That's my book cover. And actually, I have in here.
You could hold it up for the camera
here,
for those that can see
camera.
It on radio.
I don't know if you can see it. If you listen, looking at the YouTube. And in here it says, Rachel Elliott is an administrative assistant who is an almost perfect body double for her uber-rich, bitchy, nasty boss, Belinda Regan. Rachel luckily has to run an early morning errand and leaves the office before the planes demolish her office on September 11th. Her boss, Belinda, is not so lucky and is in the office during the attack. Rachel is not happy with her life. Her husband is cheating on her. She doesn't have time to finish school. And her family is very dysfunctional. She takes the opportunity to let everyone think she was the one who was killed in the towers and steps into her boss's shoes in more ways than one. So then that's the whole thing. Was it really a lucky switch?
Was it?
You know?
What inspired you to write that?
During 9/11.
You did? Okay,
I was curious. I was supposed to be there. I would have been walking, you know, I would have been there for like 10 seconds. Actually, it was like about a minute. The day before, I had an office in Livingston and an office in New York on Pine Street. Mm-hmm. And I was in Livingston the day before. And my boss at the time was in another boss's office, like just camping and working. He didn't even look up at me, this guy. He's a jerk. And he... I used to call him, his name wasn't Richard, but I used to call him the nickname for Richard.
Oh, yeah.
His name is Richard. They were looking right at him.
Yeah, no, but no offense. Like, but he was just like, he was just really a bad guy. So anyway, he didn't even look up at me. And I saw him sitting in there, and I was like, hey, and how you doing? And then he was like, he's looking out the window like he had his back to the door.
Right.
Didn't even turn around and acknowledge me. And... And I was like, he goes, yeah, hi, Wanda. And he goes, we're having a staff meeting in New York. Be there tomorrow. And then I was like, all right. And then he just kept on his computer, you know, on a laptop. And then he's like, 10 seconds later, Wanda. And I'm halfway down the hall. And I go, yeah. I come back. What's up? And he goes, never mind. You don't have to come in. You can just call in. So for that period, I would have been coming into New York. I would have been standing in front of Century 21, 8:45. I would have been looking at my watch saying, I have time to go pick up oatmeal. Ba-boom! Just like, you know.
Wow.
So I was grateful that, you know, I wasn't. I watched it on TV.
Things happen in a weird way.
Yeah, it was just very bizarre. And I, you know, in watching it, in watching
just
everything happen.
Just got chills from that. Sorry.
I was grateful. I really didn't. With all the people, I was at AIG at the time, and we really didn't lose anybody. With all the offices and all the people and all the staff that we had, and it was interesting because our company, we were one of the first, and we were also we also did a lot of things, and that was one of the things too. Like people didn't realize with the meltdown, AIG would have affected the world economy by not, you know, supporting it and giving it the money and the hand, the help that it needed during the meltdown. But they were also during 9/11, one of the leaders in helping New York City and helping a lot of other companies come up in line. Cause we were really locked and loaded and ready to go. And a lot of companies were down for months, you know, because their infrastructure couldn't handle it. And we had done so much redundancy and so much in looking at that emergency situation.
Right.
So,
that's
it was pretty incredible. So a lot of it, you know, some of it, you know, what's that statement on Law and Order? The, you know, the dun dun, and then they have the and then they have a thing like events that occur. Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean? Like whatever that statement is.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
That's my statement.
That's your statement.
That's my story.
We're talking about statements. We'll get right back to that. But talking about statements, we were talking about Recovery Coach Academy actually. So here's on to our sponsors. City of Angels Training Institute, otherwise known as CODI. Why should you attend the Recovery Coach Academy? Anyone in the Recovery Coach field should attend it. The CCAR Recovery Coach Academy is an innovative new approach to healing people's lives that is unlike any other training, utilizing a dynamic approach to learning that blends both process and content, offering a once-in-a-lifetime experience that has been referred to as pure recovery genius. If you're ready to learn, be challenged, and reap valuable rewards for life, the Recovery Coach Academy is a must for anyone in the recovery field. And it is a 7-day intensive training academy focusing on providing individuals with the skills needed to guide, mentor, and support anyone who would like to enter into or sustain long-term recovery from an addiction to alcohol or other drugs. And all the classes are held at the First Baptist Church of Hightstown, and that's in New Jersey. And the next Recovery Coach Academy class is July 7th through July 13th. And if you attend, you could get 30 CEUs. The course price is $850. And there is a special discount. If you go in and log in now and use promo code RCA450 at the checkout, you will receive the class for $400. Yes, that's right. That is a savings of $450 for a 7-day intensive training academy. And in an effort to make the Recovery Coach Academy more affordable to everyone, if you can't afford the $400 right away, CODI does offer an installment plan where you could pay $100 a month over 4 months. So for course information, visit the website www.codi.com. CodyNJ.com. CodyNJ.com. Enroll today.
We actually get to change. We're still offering that class in July that you talked about, but we're throwing another one in because we had to cancel that last class, and yep. I believe it's going to be May 7th or May 4th to the 11th.
Okay. Well, there you have it. Now we've added another class. So they could still go in and use that promo code RCA450 yep. yes. and get an incredible savings of $450.
Oh, wow.
So enroll today to get that special discount because I believe that could be a limited time offer. So you want to enroll today.
That's a big savings.
That's a huge savings.
And it's a great class.
Yes, Richie and I we just recently graduated as recovery coach professionals. Yay!
Well, thank you, Art, for that.
And I thank City of Angels for that.
City of
you,
Angels.
Kevin.
Yeah, I'm almost all done with you.
No, you still have to put up with us.
No, I got to get more classes to give me.
Yeah.
I think you've done enough for right now. Our heads are filled with all.
Actually, thought. We'll have compassion fatigue coming up soon.
I would love that because I deal with it every day in what I do.
That's a serious thing.
I do know. Yeah. So getting back to our guest here, Wanda, go ahead. Tell us how we can get the first chapter of your book.
Chapter one. It's on HTTPS, WandaEllett.wordpress.com. /2017/08/11/LuckySwitchChapter1Teaser. And then it has the ISBN number 978-098-274-54-03. But
listen
if you go
to
on
the show later if they didn't have a pen for all of that.
I know. They could but basically what I'll do, if you go on to my onto the Instagram and you look for the post that has, because you'll see the cover of the book on there, and I'll repost it underneath the show.
I was going to say, yeah, and for people who might not have Instagram, there is such people.
On Facebook, too. It's on Facebook
and
as
well.
And
where can they find that?
The Facebook page. There's a Wanda Ellett Facebook page.
Okay, and is that all one word?
Yes, Wanda, WandaEllett. And then that's a media page, and eventually I'll have like all my shows from the radio show, and also there's going to be future books as well. But if you go on there, you'll see the cover again for the book, and you'll see a couple posts. There's a couple different posts that have the link for the WordPress.
Okay.
But if you go on to Wanda Ellett, you know, the WordPress.
And if anybody wanted to find out more, do you have a Facebook page for your consulting?
Yes, G45 Consulting.
Okay.
We're also on Twitter. I've been on Twitter for years. I used to tweet positive quotes every day. But then everybody started doing that. You know, I always like to be in the front of the curves. Then I get bored with it and jump off.
And then you also have a website for your consulting?
Yeah, G45 Consulting.
Okay. And if anybody wanted to email you anything, even about this show or any of your shows, what can they do?
Wanda@G45Consulting.com. And that's Wanda, WANDA, at G like Greek, the number 4 and the number 5, consulting, like the word consulting.com.
Do you have any phone numbers?
You can call my cell, 201-527-7138.
Do not put that on a bathroom wall.
Exactly.
Just checking. Well, Wanda, it's been so nice having you as a guest.
This has been a lot of fun.
I mean, you taught us some things. Oh, don't be nervous. I mean, your brother was grand over here. I mean, when he spoke loudly. I loved it. Absolutely. And for being such a good sport in our sing-along, and good luck with your new book, Lucky
Switch.
Thank you. Yeah,
it's going to be out as an ebook on May 28th.
Oh, that's exciting.
That's the launch date on the Kindle ebook.
Well, that'll be good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, keep me posted because we'll keep announcing it for you. So I'm really excited about that. And for anybody who really wants to find out, you know, about, you know, anything in the workforce, career force, you know, Wanda Ellett is our expert here. And I think I just called you Elliot, and it's Wanda Ellett.
Right.
I did it.
Everybody does that.
I don't know why. I've been trying so hard not to do that.
Some people call me Wendy Elliott.
I did.
That's your stage name.
Wendy Elliott. And that's kind of funny. So it's, you know, it's fine. It's all cool.
Well, it's
and they can also check out about the Secret Mentor Society Boot Camp if they're interested in that.
I love that.
It's a 10-day intensive course.
I'm not going to come in pajamas. I'm coming in fatigues and maybe my little boots. I love it. But I'm so happy. Thank you
so much.
John, thank you so much for being part of the show.
You're welcome.
Really appreciated it. And Our next show is going to be Wednesday, May 15th here at COARadio.com with more special guests. And all you have to do is visit the COARadio.com website, and you'll be able to find out those special guests as we have them, because I like to keep everything secret, like the Secret Mentor Society. And Rich, I'd love to thank you for your guitar playing, your singing, your brilliance in the show. Thank you so much for being here.
Who, me?
Yes, okay. You. And Art, as always, yay, none of this can happen. None of the shows on COA Radio can happen without Art Ackerman. So
yay!
I absolutely love it. You make it all work. And thank
and
you for having
you
us
thank George.
All the time.
George.
And George and High Tech for Glow Buds. And remember, you can find these at whatsonsale.com. And I am your host, Maryann Castello, here on COA Radio for the Health and Wellness Show. Until next time, good night, everybody. Thank you.